Hi everybody, this is Jason Spruance with the Tech Bookshelf at www.techbookshelf.com, and I'm going to try to give you a quick 2-minute review of my favorite apps made for the iPad. So here we go. If you look on the home screen, I've got my favorite apps here across the bottom, the ones I use most often. We'll start with the calendar. The calendar is very pretty in here, so you can see I don't have anything tonight, but here's my schedule from the day, and then a quick rundown with all the meetings we've got. Email is a joy to work with on this. So here's my work emails. I get between 150 and 200 emails a day. So it's kind of nice to be able to just go through these. You can quickly reply, or delete emails or organize them into folders, things like that. Here you see Safari on here. It's the web browser. Happen to have the TiVo now playing list up there for my TiVos in my living room, but here's Facebook. Now there is no official Facebook app for the iPhone, but you can see on here that the Safari version of Facebook for the iPad looks pretty good. I think I said there's no official version for the iPhone, but that's the iPad. So Evernote here. Evernote is my favorite web app by far. As you can see up here, I don't know if you can see, but I did a search. This is basically my knowledge base. I have 400 notes or so in here. And I did a search for upgrade 3750. I am a network engineer, so I keep lots of information handy. So when I did a search for that, it came up with how to upgrade 3750 right there. And there's the command to upgrade to 3750. Or you've also got recovering this document, how to recover a password on a 2900 or a 3750. So this is my favorite web app by far. This is where I keep all my notes. You can see I can also keep things like shipping labels and things like that in here, just for reference. I'll get to the Amazon app now, I guess. So you can see the Kindle app here. It is, to me, a replacement for a Kindle. So here's a book that I was reading about disciplining your kids, not really disciplining, but raising good children. So the Kindle app works nice. This is a different kind of reader. This is a PDF reader called GoodReader, and it's actually more than a reader. It's a file management system. So you can see I got a couple videos on here. And it's kind of nice because you can just upload the video straight without having to go through iTunes. The same goes for PDFs. So if I go look at, say, manuals here, and for my work, I want to look at some of these PDFs like upgrading, or look at the Nexus 7000 VPC white paper. You can see it's really nice PDF reader. So you've got good information at your fingertips. So far, this video is a heck of a lot longer than 2 minutes, so I'm going to try to go fast. It's got a good Twitter app for doing Twitter on here. The news apps are awesome. For instance, I can go and look at the Wall Street or the New York Times editor's choice. It's going to take a second to load up here. But here's the New York Times. I can click on this story. Oops, sorry. Click on this story here, and it's a beautiful, beautiful display. I know that Rupert Murdoch has said this might be the savior of the newspaper industry. Same goes for things like CNN and ESPN. They have a good portal. The last couple of things I'm going to show you are some of my favorite multimedia apps. This is one called Air Video, and this actually pulls video. I can actually pull video from my computer over the internet if I want. So this is live video playing from my computer if I want. I have all these movies over here. We'll just take a look at, say, Casino Royale for now. This is streaming live from my computer, so I can watch this video anywhere that I have on my computer if I wish. So you can see there's other movies in here. And of course there's lots of good games. So, one of the major ones is Wii Rule. That's it's a Farmville kind of app that you would see. And then there's a ton of kids games like this one for coloring. Go through here and say, let's work on this picture.
You can draw the sun in the sky and a hat on the boy's head. Have fun coloring the rest.
Change the brush strokes here, and my kids love playing with these apps. So there you go. That's a 5-minute review of the iPad, but or iPad apps. But hope that was helpful. Thanks again, and the website once again is www.techbookshelf.com.